All right, here, it's not discrimination in the way that you normally think about it, but Marcus Scribner, our friend from Black-ish, here with his friend Noelle Stevenson from Shira and the Princess of Power, season two of Netflix. It's all going so well. So when you're shooting Black-ish on the Disney lot and you want to go up to that secret Marvel floor, what happens?
We get immediately kicked out. Marvel is not for us basic Disney employees slash ABC employees. You got to have the blue badge. And for those of you who don't know, there's a blue and green badge for ABC Studios. Greens are like kind of removed, and then blues are like executives, people who work directly for Disney. Right. And we do not get access to the blue stuff.
Okay, and now for you, you've essentially saved Netflix by a revival cartoon where Marcus is one of the voices, and you believe that they have kombucha on tap.
That's what I've heard.
Wow.
It's a mythical place.
But you've never been in the building.
I haven't been.
And they won't let you in the building.
No, I mean, it's not that I've tried.
Right.
I haven't launched my heist yet.
Right.
But...
no, they have unicorns.
They have unicorns.
Oh, my.
But here's the crazy thing.
I believe it.
16 stories, no jacuzzi.
No jacuzzi.
No,
outrageous, Sam. I can't believe it.
I would think Anthony Anderson has a jacuzzi in his trailer.
Probably. I've been in his trailer. He's got like at least three different rooms in a singular trailer. I've got one basic.
How many jacuzzis?
Yeah.
How many jacuzzis do you have?
I don't know. I have zero jacuzzis. I have a shower. God.
That's good.
Okay.
That's flexworthy, you know?
All right. Enough of this. To this. Jessica knew it. Depending on your age, Shira was what?
Shira,
excuse me.
She-Ra was an 80's property, this part of the Masters of the Universe. She's He-Man's twin sister, but actually has never been rebooted until now. So that's us.
Until now, thanks to you.
Yeah.
So was it just like a lightning bolt, or somebody said, hey, go do this?
No, I mean, it was something that they were looking for someone to pitch this series, to reboot it, to bring it back into the modern era. And I was like, I volunteer.
So, okay.
Yeah. She's the gal.
Yeah. But you weren't really familiar with She-Ra because you weren't alive.
You're too young.
I wasn't, no. Yeah, I did my research.
And did you like the original?
The original's amazing.
Yeah.
It's like even at the time, like there was no other shows like She-Ra. Like it's this action adventure show starring like almost an entirely female cast except for Bo. but yeah, I mean it was really exciting for the time and it's exciting for now.
And then Marcus auditioned essentially, or you said, we need a voice, we need a studly male voice?
No, I would never just get the role off bat like
he
that.
He actually walked in and he looks a lot like his character, and I saw him, I was like, oh my gosh, that's him. Like, don't, it's just how he sounds. Don't like, you know, not on how he looks. And then he like opens his mouth. I'm like, oh, that's Bo, that's him, that's right there. So it was the easiest choice ever.
All right, well, good. Well, here's a clip. Observe, watch.
Bo, look, I got one.
Adora, get away from it!
What just happened?
It looks like the bots can self-destruct.
Ugh, Catra.
We can't let that one self-destruct!
Everyone, together!
Whoopsies. You ready, Ice Princess?
Yeah!
Tons of fun. Is it fun to do? Because you do have the perfect voice for it.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's a ton of fun. Like, I feel like voiceover is like kind of stress therapy because you just go in and you just get to yell at a mic in your pajamas. Like,
nice.
What is more fun than that? So, yeah, it's definitely, it's a blast.
Are you paid in money or in kombucha?
cartoon money.
Okay, cartoon money. There you go.
But cool.
No, it's in my head. I was going to say She-Ra, but I mean to say Shira.
No, you were right the first time.
She-Ra, season two, premieres on Netflix on April the 26th. Really nice to meet you, sir.
You as well. Thank you so much for having
Guys.
Still
we got the swords.